Thank you very much for invitation to this symposium. And culture is always a tricky word. And I started my career in Moscow. And when 30 years ago, I started to study Russian in Moscow. And always Russian friends and Russian old ladies cursed me, "You are not cultural. It means you are not a cultural person." And so culture is always a tricky thing. But I agree with other speakers that today we mean culture as in a wider sense, as values or as approaches to the life or wide sense of attitude. And in this sense, it's very important for us these days to cultivate ourselves about culture. It's very important. And today I want to introduce some history of Japanese cultural diplomacy and also of Japan and also our challenges. And this is a content of today's speech. And first, I will explain our history, and then today's cultural diplomacy of Japan, and thirdly, strengths and challenges of Japanese cultural diplomacy, and fourth, finally, conclusions. And firstly, about history of Japanese cultural diplomacy. And as Mark mentioned, yes, we have Japan Foundation. And these buildings, the left one is the headquarters. It's not so much impressive building, but more impressive buildings are in Beijing and in Paris. We spent a lot of money to construct such big buildings in important cities. And now Japan Foundation has more than 20 offices abroad. I'm sorry that this letter is a bit small, but before World War II, Japan started cultural diplomacy. And I know that in 1932, Goethe Institute was established, and in 1934, British Council was established. And then Japan also started some efforts in cultural diplomacy field. And after World War II, Japan slowly started, restarted its cultural diplomacy efforts. But in 1970s, along with the rise of Japanese economy, the government of Japan started, accelerated their efforts to develop cultural diplomacy. And in 1972, the Japan Foundation was established by special law. And then Prime Minister Fukuda stressed that Japan should convey correct understanding to the world about peace-loving and cultural state of Japan. At that time, this was the purpose to establish, to develop our cultural diplomacy. And also in 1975, Japan started ODA, Official Development Aid Program, in cultural field. So we give money to developing countries to protect their cultural heritages. And in 1980s, there were some new challenges. And in 1976, Foreign Press Center was established. This is a building of Foreign Press Center, but not whole building, some one or two floors. And this is a non-governmental organization, but the government of Japan is closely related. And also, in 1980s, the Japanese government and other organizations and Japan Foundation started large-scale Japanese language education program in Beijing. And the building in Beijing, which I showed previously, was the place where many Chinese students learned Japanese language. And in 1980s and 1990s, in the United States, there was a theory that Japanese are different people, and Japanese are from different civilization. So economic conflicts are inevitable. Such theory came to appear. So it alerted Japanese government and Japanese people, and we decided to explain to American friends that we are not from different civilization. Maybe we are from different civilization, but it is not the cause of economic conflict. And as you may know, we love tuna, and we buy a lot of tuna from Croatia. And this is win-win trade for both, because Croatian people don't eat much tuna, and Japanese people are very happy to buy tuna. So, you know, because of the difference of culture, of food, of eating, you know, there is no economic conflict, but this is perfect trade for both of us. So different culture does not bring conflict. But sometimes, you know, a difference of culture might be referred as the cause of conflict. So we should be very careful on that point. Well, and so during that period, it was main task for the Japanese cultural diplomacy to explain to Americans and to some extent to Europeans that, you know, if there are problems, we should try to solve. But you should not refer to the difference of culture or difference of civilization. Okay. And then in 1990s, Japan started to invite foreign young English teacher to Japan. It is called JET program. And so now native English speakers, a lot of native English speakers are working in Japan. It's a very successful program. And also our compatriot Japanese Mr. Matsura Koichiro worked as Secretary General of UNESCO from 1999 to 2009. And in that way, we promoted international cooperation in cultural field. In 1995, we put special efforts to accelerate and finish the reconciliation process with neighboring Asian countries. And I think my friend Boyko, Slovenian ambassador, touched upon a little bit about this issue. Yes, still for you and for former Yugoslavian countries, and even for us, which, you know, we finished the war and colonial rule a long time ago, but it's still a big task for us still. I'm not so much pleased to say this, but we need to put more efforts for reconciliations. And in 1995, it was 50th anniversary after the end of the World War II, Japanese government inaugurated Peaceful Friendship and Exchange Program. And it was under socialist government, and they are more eager to promote reconciliation process. And in that context, in 2001, we opened Asia History Archives Center in Tokyo. And in this center, you have free access to the old documents during World War II and before World War II. And even through internet, you can access to the documents. So that we wanted to help historians to have free access to the documents and also free discussion on the history. In this century, yes, there was 9/11. And then in 2004, there was an advisory group on cultural diplomacy for the Prime Minister, Mr. Koizumi. At that time, Koizumi was Prime Minister. And there are several suggestions and recommendations. And first, cultural exchange and cooperation are important for strengthening diplomacy of Japan. Second, we should promote mutual understanding among cultures and civilizations. So at that time, dialogue among different cultures and civilizations were very fashionable. And I remember that Iranian president also promoted this. And thirdly, we should try hard to promote common values and ideals. And I often hear in Croatia that you have a European value. And that's fine. That's fine for me. But the problem or next task for us is then how to make common values between European values and we don't say Asian values. It's another another maybe challenges and tasks for Asians. But anyway, we should promote somehow common values This is our task. And then in 2006, Japan Foundation established Japan-China Exchange Center. And at that time, I was in Beijing, and you know, in this context, we invited, Japanese government invited a lot of Chinese young people to Japan to help them to understand Japan. And this, there are my faces. It's a bit younger, a few years ago, but I talked to Chinese students and young people. And the background is that Japan-China economic relations are growing. And before, Japan-US trade was biggest for Japan. But in 2004, China became number one trade partner, and US is number two. So for Japanese economy, China became more and more important. And also, Japanese companies made a lot of investment in China. And you might be very much surprised, but now in China, about 9 million Chinese are working for Japanese companies and factories in China. So economically, we have so huge relations with China. But it does not necessarily mean that mutual understanding between Japan and China are enough. Okay, today's cultural diplomacy of Japan. Of course, Croat people knows Lisinski Hall and Opera House in Rijeka and Osijek. And Japanese government have cooperation with these cultural institutions in Croatia. These are some list how Japanese government supported Croatian cultural institutions when Croatia was in troubles. So my predecessors worked very hard, but it was a very pleasant job to extend support to Croatian cultural institutions from Japanese government. And still, when I visit these institutions, such as Rijeka Opera House or Osijek Opera House, they always express gratitude to the donation from the Japanese government. And it's very pleasant. And meanwhile, I was in China from 2004 to 2007, and I was press minister in charge of culture and press. So my job was to meet with Chinese journalists and explain to them about Japanese policy. And for example, this is a journal published in China. And I explained how Japan teaches history to the Japanese children, because it is one of controversial points between Japan, China, and I would say South Korea. And I explained to Chinese journalists how Japan teaches history and how Japanese history textbooks are made. And I'm very much grateful that Chinese journalists put what I explained. So I am very much grateful to Chinese journalists. But please look, this is my part. Black part is my part, and white part is Chinese friend, Chinese spokesperson of the foreign ministry, and I'm sorry, but South Korean friend from embassy of South Korea in Beijing, and they are white. So I asked the editor-in-chief, why you put my part black, and why Chinese and South Korean part is white? Yeah. And he told me, oh, Mr. Ide, you don't know, in China, black color is very cool. You know, this is our culture. So, you know, so that's why very important to understand the culture. Thank you for your understanding of difference of culture. Okay, so I skip this. And so, what's the achievement, and what's the strength, and what achievement of Japanese cultural diplomacy, and what's the problem? And I'm happy to note that in Croatia, Japanese culture is very popular, and I took some websites from cultural organizations in Zadar, And Japanese martial arts are very popular. I know Korean martial arts also very popular. And there are, you know, Japanese food restaurants in Zagreb, so you can enjoy sushi in several Zagreb restaurants, Akamaru, Manzoku Sushi, Jinja Sushi, etc. And I learned that Mr. Bandage loves sushi. He visited one of the restaurants. And you know, cartoons and these cartoons are very popular. Karaoke, originally it was invented in Japan, but it's very popular. Some strange figure dolls and costume play. And this was originally invented in Japan, but now it's worldwide, it's popular. And Japanese Foreign Ministry officially started to support annual World Costume Play Competition in Aichi, Japan. And personally, I wonder why the Foreign Ministry should support such event. But this is a decision by then Foreign Minister, Mr. Aso. And you know, there are many, many things. And so maybe I jump to a conclusion in order to save the time. You know, cultural diplomacy should not be just propaganda or exotism. Yeah, I know many people, Croats love Japanese culture as exotism or business promotion. But cultural diplomacy should be part of important work to promote mutual understanding, to help to identify common interests between people and nations. So in this sense, I am fully in line, in the same line with him. And this is, if I understand correctly, this is what he said in the first beginning. And we have still a lot of homeworks to do. We need to put more energy. And so I wish to have more cooperation with friends in Croatia and other countries. Thank you very much.